فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah, have the taqwa of Allah, and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. Today, inshallah, like usually, like every day and every Jum'ah, we're talking about Allah. When we talk about Allah, we talk about Allah Himself, His names, His attributes. Or we're talking about the order of Allah. Or we're talking about the favor of Allah. Or we're talking about the promise of Allah. So everything concentrate and focusing on Allah, because this is the main thing why we are here. And today I choose to talk to you about Allah in one or two words. One is ism and one is sifa. As for the ism or the noun is al-wadud. Al-wadud. And as for the sifa or the attribute is love and hub. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of his names is Al-Wadud. And the Wadud, Al-Wadud, the loving one. Not the one who loves, but also the one that who loved by others. So Al-Wadud is a special name of Allah. It comes as a result of this, the hub of Allah. And the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's something very important that Muslim to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-wadud. And if you don't know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the loving one, all what you need to try to focus a little bit about the story of yourself before your existence. Look to the story of Adam alayhi salam. Go back again to your father and how that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had announced the existence, and we can maybe use the expression of the birth, but I would say the existence of you to the best of those who worship him in the time. Inni ja'ilun fil ardi khalifa. Indeed, I'm making a khalifa in the earth. Allah is informing the angels that you going to be in existence, that you coming. So the news, the good news, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that out of his love, he announcing your existence. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after your existence, he made you to exist and to dwell in Jannah. So you can know your originality, your hometown, your birthplace. So you can be always anxious and thinking about going back to from where you came. And when you came to this life in the form of your father Adam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught you. He didn't leave you to be ignorant. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا ثُمَّ عَرَضَهُمْ عَلَى الْمَلَائِكَةِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one, He gave you the information, gave you the teaching in the form of Adam, and He gave him the name of all things, and to show your superiority over all other things, even the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had ordered the angels to prostrate to Adam. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, remember when we command the angel to prostrate to Adam. is because that Allah loves you. And Allah loves you, doesn't matter if you are a Muslim or non-Muslim. And you can see the love of Allah, and the ihsan of Allah, and the goodness of Allah, and the generosity of Allah. If you say Allah, la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, or you are saying that Jesus, Son of God, a'udhu billahi min thalik, wa ta'ala Allahu an thalik aluwan kabira. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made the food, the water, the drink, everything, even for those who disbelieve in Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was able and capable that those who deny Him or associate partner beside Him, that He will make them starving to death so they can acknowledge Him. But He's so generous. He's so good. He is Al-Wadud. And He is the one that He loves, and also is the one that to be loved. And people love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because His generosity. But why Allah have to love us? This is something amazing, because this is Al-Wadud subhanahu wa ta'ala, the loving one. Because this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And still, even the love of Allah will accompany Adam when he disobeyed. And when he comes out of Jannah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him a word, as he told us in Quran, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ. So Adam had received words from his Lord. So he teach you, and he gave you the way how to turn back to him, and how to seek the forgiveness. فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ, he received a word. Allah didn't leave him to be wonder how he can come back on the track. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he is al-wadud, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ, he received a word from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he repeated, he said it, he meant it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted him. And Allah welcomed him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had even kept his enemy out of Jannah for his arrogancy and not prostrating to him and not for him to dwell in Jannah. So we can see that the love of Allah had accompanied the birth or the existence of our father Adam, and is still with us today. Regardless how bad we are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still the loving one. Because وَلَوْ يُؤَاخِذُ اللَّهُ النَّاسَ بِمَا كَسَبُوا مَا تَرَكَ عَلَىٰ ظَهْرِهَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ. If Allah treated us in fairness according our shortcoming and our sins, Allah said He will not leave one single soul in this earth. How many times would we stop praying? How many times that we cheated? How many times that we said? How many times we did things breaking the law? And still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't cause us to die in the same second. But Allah repeated again, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ. Allah repeating it again and giving you the chance again and again that you can come back to Him. Because He is what? He is al-Wadud subhanahu wa ta'ala. And somebody may say, how Allah can be al-Wadud, the loving one? And after this we see the disasters, we see the hardship, we see the sickness, the illness, the poverty, the earthquake, all these things. It is that out of love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the human being came out of the track, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him something to remind them, to bring them back to the mercy of Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will make bala and will make disaster falling on them, so they wake up and they get back to Allah and they seek Allah His forgiveness, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a means of tawbah and forgiveness for them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in every second of your life, you can see His love, you can see His kindness, you can see that He is al-Wadud. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told us about this beautiful name in the Quran in Surah Al-Buruj. وَمَا نَقَمُوا مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا أَنْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ الَّذِي لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Continuing until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ رَبَّكَ وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الْوَدُودِ ذُو الْعَرْشِ الْمَجِيدِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-ghafoor, the most forgiving, the one who forgives again and again and again, and also is al-wadood, the loving one, the one that who love and the one to be loved, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can search in our life, we can look right and left and see the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This love for everybody, even those that say that Jesus Son of God, He still giving them to eat, He still giving them air to breathe, He still giving them water to drink. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He did not give them what they deserve, but because He is the loving one subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it can reach to the level of the wilaya, that you became the friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Out of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that men made from the sons of Adam, messengers, awliya, shuhada, salihin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made from Adam's sons some people who reach to be speaking with Allah directly, like Musa alayhi salam. Allah yastafi min al-mala'ikati rusulan wa min al-nas. Allah selected from the angels and from a human being, messenger. They communicate with Allah through Jibreel or directly, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked to Musa. But me and you, we could not be a prophet, we could not be a messenger. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had opened it wide for us. We can be righteous people. We can be awliya of Allah. We can be friends of Allah. We can be from those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they call in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that among the people, لَوْ أَقْسَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ لَأَبَرَّهِ. Among the people whom that if they ask and demand something from Allah, Allah will answer him immediately. But we have to work, and we have to do our homework to be among these ones. Allah loves and He be loved, and make means and ways for us to be loved. بعث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رجلا على سرية فكان يقرأ لهم ويأمهم فإذا ختم ختم بقل هو الله أحد فلما رجعوا شكوا إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال سألوه لماذا يفعل ذلك فذهبوا إليه وسألوه قال لأنها صفة الرحمن وأنا أحبها فقال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما معناه أخبروه أن الله سبحانه وتعالى يحبه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم sent an expedition and he put iman over them to be their amir. And he used to lead them in the salah. And every time he leads them in the salah, he will end the recitation with the statement of Allah, قل هو الله أحد. Say, He is Allah, the one and the only one. He is the master. He's a sayyid. He is the one that everything beseech him. And he doesn't need anyone or ask anyone. He is not born. He has no father. Neither he has son. لم يلد ولم يولد. And ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. And is no equal to him. No, nothing to resemble him. Not a mother nature, not a black man, not Jesus, not anything. He is unique in everything. The first without beginning, the last without end. He is the one that وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَا يَؤُدُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمِ. They said, what's wrong with you? Every time, read a surah or read قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. Why I have to be Surah Al-Ghashiyah and after this year end was قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. it have to be in Surah Al-Imran, and after this we end with Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad. Choose one of both. He said, this is what I like to do. You want my leadership, my imamah, or not? So he used to be the best one among them who recite. So they left it. They did not keep debating with each other. Drop your information and keep walking. Make your information known, and this is it. They left it. But when they went back to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, informed him. He said, every rak'ah and every salah, he finished, now he ended with Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to them, go and ask him, why you do this? They went to the man, who are you used to lead us, and every time Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad in every rak'ah. Say, because this is the quality and the description of Almighty Allah. This is the attributes, the qualification of Almighty Allah. As a result of this, I love it. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when they came to him, and they said, he said so and so, he said, go and inform him that Allah loves him. The love of Allah, the best thing, the ibadah of the qalb, of the heart, more value than the ibadah and the worship by the lips, the hub and the love, the intention, the iman, all these acts of